and welcome to this video looking at the Banker's Top 1000 World Banks ranking for 2021. I'm Kimberley Long, Asia Editor of The Banker, and today I'm speaking with Joy Macknight, who is the Editor of The Banker. Thanks for joining me, Joy.
Thanks, Kim.
So to start off with, can you talk me through some of the really big global trends that we've seen this year in the rankings?
Yeah, so this year, the top 1,000 covers banks in 102 countries. So you can really, we really have oversight of the health and the wealth of the global banking industry. And to be honest, it's been quite a good year, you know, under the circumstances. So the banks across the globe, in aggregate, have managed to increase their Tier 1 capital by 13% to $9.9 trillion, which is, you know, the highest ever. They've also managed to increase their asset base by 16%. And also their deposits by 17%. So overall, not bad picture. You know, I think some of the things like the NPA, non-performing loans that some people were talking about, that hasn't come to fruition. But of course, again, most of the countries still have in place their COVID support packages. So, you know, the hit to the bank's balance sheet hasn't been seen yet. Mm. But the other hit maybe is around the profitability. So profits were down across the globe by 18%, but if you compare it to the global financial crisis, where profits dropped by 85%, again, it's much less in terms of, you know, the crisis. Let's talk a little bit about Asia. Obviously, China, the Chinese banks are still the engine of growth for the world's banking system. You know, tell us a little bit about some of the trends that you've seen in China.
China, even though the hit of the pandemic last year, has still been a real huge economy and is still kind of leading the way in terms of GDP growth. And I think that's reflected really in the banks. So once again, we're seeing the Chinese banks occupying the top four places in the top 1,000 ranking, you know, kind of as has been the situation for the last few years now. And ICBC again is taking the top spot there. So it's still a really big story there in terms of the success of those banks. And, you know, they're posting like double-digit growth in terms of their Tier 1 capital. So it's they're still accumulating huge sums as well. Is actually, though, slightly further down the ranking, though, Postal Savings Bank got the biggest increase in Tier 1 capital for Chinese banks with over 30% increase. So, I mean, it's a huge success story there still for the Chinese banks.
Can you tell me a little bit about other countries in Asia? You know, which countries' banking systems have done quite well? Which countries' banking systems have maybe struggled a bit?
One country that's not really done so well this year is Indonesia. So after last year's results showed that the banks did really well and actually posted close to 20% increase in Tier 1 capital, this year has been not so great. You know, most of the banks have seen a decline in their capital. And I think this is probably down to a hit from the COVID pandemic and how that's hit the country's GDP and the response to the pandemic in the country. And also as well, they're coming under stricter rules as well around Tier 1 capital going forward. So I think this might in turn impact them slightly more in the future. But looking to a more better success story is actually Taiwan. So I think Taiwan's response to the coronavirus pandemic has been very well documented. They moved very quickly to suppress the virus. And because of that, the economy stayed widely open throughout 2020. And, you know, there was a really strong growth in the country's GDP. It was nearly 3% in 2020. And also the manufacturing sectors stayed open as well. So they did really well. And because of that, the bank's results is also reflecting that too. So Taiwan's banks have seen some really good growth in their Tier 1 capital this year as well.
Let's look at, let's say, Australia, obviously a part of Asia-Pacific, but if you exclude Japan and China, the Australian banks also have done quite well.
Yeah, they did pretty well this year too. So like last year, they've occupied the top four places in the Asia-Pacific ranking, excluding Japan and China. And they've all seen increases in Tier 1 capital in these top four banks as well. So it's been a really good year for them. And actually, they've still managed to retain their positions in the top 1,000, almost exactly the same as last year, which is something that's not been seen that much. There's been quite a lot of movement up and down for a few other banks across the region. So Australia's banks seem to perform pretty well this year. And hopefully that's something that's going to kind of carry on forwards for them as well in the future.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your insights, Kim.